young.
What do you know? It still
works. What are you going to do? It is. See, we like to talk before we, a little behind the scenes.
You mean this is all on the air?
Not just this right now.
Oh, no.
Hey, it's Kid Friday. We do this show because you are a kid in a digital world. I'm Dave. And I don't know why we get so many requests, but our good friend Steve, way over there.
Hi.
He's back. His son Alex, who is in military school. We're going to be learning about that. He's also learning. He'll tell us about how we can grow tulips for some odd reason. I have no idea where that's coming up from. What is that? Were you in Amsterdam recently or something, Alex?
I haven't been anywhere. I can't tell you anything about tulips.
Then why did you mention that before we started the show? I'm very confused.
I didn't.
Okay. If you say so. All right. Now,
there's
Steve,
do you have
okay, no. Hey, we're going to be talking about, the big explosion, the Samsung blow-up, and the discontinuation of the tablet. Can't buy it. All right, we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the phones. We're going to talk about how, we saw last week, we talked about the Jeep that was on fire in the last show.
Yeah.
And we got the video. We're going to show you the video. Guy left his Samsung phone on and plugged in, and his car is in the driveway. Had to run inside for something. Came back. Uh-oh.
There was another incident on an airplane. I'll have to tell you about that one.
Really? Can't wait to hear about that. Also, going to tell you about how, I can't fix anything, but I can because of YouTube. And so many people can. And it's amazing. We'll talk about that. Also, Alex, the tulips. I don't know where the tulips are coming from.
You can probably figure out how to grow tulips on YouTube.
I don't know. But the real bottom line is that Steve here really wants to get a rotisserie chicken. And so he said,
please, when can we do this show? Can we please start? I have to get a rotisserie chicken.
So, Alex, can you say start the show?
Start the show.
Hit it. Hit it. Hit it.
Oh!
Let's get this party started.
We're all right!
Yeah, I'm a kid. I love computers. I have an iPod. I'm a gadget freak. I like to play with my display. I do it every day. I have awesome technique. Yeah, I'm a Kid Friday.
Kid Friday.
I love this stuff, can't you see? Yeah, I'm a Kid Friday.
Kid Friday.
I'm a kid who's in love with technology. Kid Friday.
Kid Friday. It's part of the good folks at Story Cub. Video versions of children's picture books. If you are a parent, your kids should be watching Story Cub. If you're a kid, you should be watching Story Cub. If you're a chihuahua, you might be in a Story Cub video picture book. Video versions of children's picture books, a great way for pre-readers, for kindergartners, for first graders, second graders, and even eighth graders. Alex, what grade are you in?
Ninth.
Oh, I was so close. I forgot. Ninth, even ninth graders. It's awesome. Video versions of children's picture books. How much better can it get? Well, the only way I guess it could get any better is if, you threw a rotisserie chicken in there. Okay?
There it is again.
Look at that. See that rotisserie? And it's going around. Just like a rotisserie.
I was going to say the answer is none. None better until you put the rotisserie chicken up there. Look at that. Delicious.
That's a, look at that, huh?
Oh, shiny.
All right. Well, let's get back to us. And, we are... Kid Friday is viewed in 214 countries. So, Alex, come on. Let's wave to the kids around the world. Wave.
Hello.
It's the Kid Friday wave. Are you waving, Alex? All right. Last time your dad said stop. No, he said hola or hold on. Or something like that. All right. Do you want to see the chicken again?
Don't tease me.
Look at that. He wants the chicken.
Oh, man.
Are you going to Costco for the chicken?
Going to try to.
Are you? Okay.
We're getting one from somewhere.
Why? Did they close early or what?
What time do they close?
6 o'clock.
Okay, well.
That's all right, on Sundays.
I could use that. Well, who knows what day anyone's watching this. It's a rotisserie chicken extravaganza on Story Cub. There is actually a great story called I Have a Restaurant. But the thing is this. You go, if you have an iOS device, an iPhone, an iPad, you go on the App Store, get the free Story Cub app, and watch the story of the day every day for free. Now, you can also go to StoryCub.com, and you can do the same there. You can watch the story of the day every day, the video story. It's great for bedtime, you know? It's like, what's that show you like to watch at night?
Which show?
That one that you were talking to. Okay, let's just talk about Alex here. Okay, so let's say Alex is like, oh, that Tulip show is coming on, right? Okay, so and let's say he's in ninth grade, but let's just say he has a cousin sleeping over, and he's, hey, I got a great bedtime story for you. Check it out. It's Story Cub, and he goes back to his Tulip show on public television, and everybody's happy. You know how it works? Okay. Again, I forgot to put in the little cubby bear running out thingy. So we're just going to spin this out. And thanks to Story Cover for being a sponsor here on the old Kid Friday. All right. So, Alex, when did you become interested in the tulip?
I'm not.
I don't. Well, then why did you bring it up?
I didn't.
That's all I want to know. That's all I want to know. Steve, if we can, I want to just share this with you. Look at that. That again? Is a rotisserie chicken. I'm not teasing you with the chicken.
I thought we were talking about kids and technology, and instead, oh, look at that.
You just like that?
Look at that. It's like falling out of the pan.
You know what? The only thing it needs is above it is the Kid Friday little spinning.
That's even better.
Do you want it to spin around? Can we just have it spin just like?
I kind of like how it tumbles like that.
Oh, do you? Yeah. Well, here are your options, okay? Do you like this, though? Look at that. It's like a sphere. We can make that larger as well.
That's a little... Then you can't really read it, though.
Okay. Then how about this?
This is technology,
look at this.
Folks.
Look at this. How about that? You can read it nice. I can make it go faster or slower.
Maybe a little bit faster.
A little bit faster?
Just a little bit.
A little bit faster. Okay. Oops. Oh, am I doing that right? Hold on.
Just a
wee bit faster. Oh, yeah. Here we go.
A wee bit
Found
faster.
It. Found it. Is it going faster?
You're watching technology in action,
I think I slowed it down. Did I slow it down?
Oh, my gosh. It's going the other direction.
Look at that. Okay, all right. I better not mess with it, but I think I'm going to do this. How about this? Can we make it a little bigger? Huh? What do you think?
That's a good size right there. You don't want to overshadow that chicken, though.
It's a rotisserie chicken. It's a rotisserie chicken, if you can believe that. You like the rotisserie chicken?
Love it.
So... The show is, we do the show, it's about kids and technology, and we're going to be talking, you know what? I did watch a video on YouTube on these machines that make the rotisserie chickens. I kid you not. You know what I like to do is when I'm eating something, I like to go to see how it's made, the factory or whatever. If I'm eating beef jerky, right? I go to the beef jerky, watch the factory, right? And I happen to be eating a rotisserie chicken. And I watched a YouTube video about these machines. And there's also a place in California that has a chain of these rotisserie chicken places. And the guy was talking about the rotisserie chicken and how they make them and how the whole thing.
You know, the guy in the middle here.
It's interesting.
The guy in the middle here on Kid Friday.
I want to make that logo smaller there. Yeah?
Speaking of going to YouTube to learn things, we didn't have this when we were kids, but... Imagine if we did, because you can find out directions and instructions to do almost anything. And the guy in the middle here, Alex, several years ago, you learned a bunch of magic tricks, the Rubik's Cube, trick basketball shots, right?
The secret's out.
Lots of kids go to YouTube. Yeah, you did. Lots of kids go to YouTube. You still do, but when you were the younger kid, you were always on YouTube looking to learn different things. I mean, if you need to figure it out, you could probably find it on YouTube, right? Isn't that how you figured out the Rubik's Cube?
Yeah.
Yeah. And now, what's your record? 58 seconds?
Like 35.
You can solve a Rubik's Cube in 35 seconds.
Not anymore.
Get up there, Alex.
You got to be a little closer.
Can you hear yourself through the headphones?
Yeah.
That's the whole idea. Get up there.
I can hear myself.
Are you too loud?
No.
Oh.
Didn't you learn magic tricks from YouTube?
Yes.
Before the card tricks?
Mm-hmm.
You were pretty good at it for a while.
And then is that how you learned about tulips?
No.
It's not.
Okay.
But tonight he's going to check out YouTube on how to grow tulips, because I bet you it's on there.
Okay, we're going to talk about the Samsung burning phones, but first, what I think we should do during this show is maybe tease Steve with these rotisserie chickens.
You're killing me.
Different shots of rotisserie
Look
chickens.
At that. There's
No, that's a 7 spit, I think.
18
One,
of
two,
them on
three,
there.
Four, five. No, it's a 6 spit.
6 times it's 3 a, is 18.
But they make different sizes. You can go on YouTube and you can see the Flom something or other machine, which is supposed to be a good one, according to them. Okay, so Samsung, it's very interesting in that there's some problems. With the
Still.
Phone, and well, major. The Department of Transportation says you cannot bring one on a plane. Period.
In fact,
you can't bring it on a plane.
One last week, was it last week? I think it was on a Southwest Airlines flight.
I'm gonna throw this on.
The
here.
Guy,
throw a burning phone on.
So the guy had a Samsung. What is it? The S7, and he turned it off, and it actually caught on fire after he turned it off. They were getting ready to take off. They were sitting on the runway. You know, doing the instructions. If you have a Samsung, you know, all the cell phones and, you know, cell phones, electronic devices must be turned off, blah, blah, blah. And if you have a Samsung S7, you're not allowed to have it on this flight, you know, like we've been talking about. Apparently this guy had one and he turned it off. And the crazy thing is it caught fire after he turned it off. It burned through the carpeting on the floor of the plane down into the subfloor underneath the carpeting. So it burnt through about 4 or 5 inches worth of flooring on the airplane. But the crazy thing is it caught fire after he turned it off.
Really? You know what that is? That's crazy. Want to see another picture? Well, I'll show you another picture. So after he turned it off, what you're saying is that...
I guess it was getting hot anyway, but he turned it off, and then that's when it started smoking and it caught on fire.
Sounds like Nelly. If you know what I mean.
Okay.
It's getting hot in
here.
Is that what it is? Something like that. So the Department of Transportation, this is like serious stuff because, hold on, I'm trying to get my notes together.
So the the Samsung Galaxy Note 7, that's the tablet phone, right?
The tablet, yeah. But first I wanted to kind of go over it a little bit more, if I can, on what... So the U.S. Department of Transportation, I've never heard of anything like this, right? Matter of fact, I gotta make it bigger. I can't see for nothing. Let me see here. So I still can't see. I think now I can see. All right.
And they recalled these phones once already, right?
Well, yeah, this
and
has nothing to do with
them?
But Samsung did it on their own, and then now, so the U.S. Department of Transportation with the Federal Aviation Administration and the Pipeline and Hazardous Materials Safety. No wonder we're spending so much money. How many administrations have you got here? So they just announced that it's an emergency order to ban all Samsung Galaxy Note 7 smartphone devices from air transportation in the United States.
That's a first.
So if you own a phone, well, first off, Samsung's doing a total recall on the whole thing. So bring your phone back. I'll tell you about that in just a second. They want all of them back, all of the phones, because the second batch blew up too. Had same problems. So check this out, though. I mean, think everyone has a phone, right? You're going on a trip. You go on an airplane. Do you bring your phone? Are we boring you to
awake
a boy?
There, Alex?
Huh? Okay. So individuals who possess a Samsung Galaxy Note 7 device may not transport the device on their person. That means you can't carry it. In your carry-on luggage or in your checked luggage on the flights to and from within the United States. It includes all Samsung Galaxy Note 7 devices. The phones also cannot be shipped as air cargo. And the ban took effect on October 15th.
I wonder if you can still get these right now today. I mean, are
no,
they still shipping any?
No,
Samsung?
No.
Or
no,
did they replace
no,
them?
Like on eBay.
No, Samsung, you know what? If anything, they may be become valuable because maybe a collectible.
Check
eBay. If it doesn't burn up.
That's true.
Well, you, because here, let me show you another picture. I mean, this is dangerous stuff. This is, you know, that's that could start something pretty wacky.
So don't iPhones give you a warning if your phone's kind of warm or very hot?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and they actually shut down.
Okay, because I have an S5, Samsung Galaxy S5, and I'm pretty sure it doesn't give me a warning, but I can feel that thing get really warm sometimes.
Well, you know, the good thing about you having an S5?
Yeah.
Is, see, for once, it pays off to be cheap. Just saying.
So I'm saving money by not having to replace anything that catches on fire, is what you're saying.
I'm saying that you're too cheap to upgrade, and it paid off.
I think it's called frugal.
Okay, so.
It's reverent.
I still want my Windows phone.
So a couple days ago, Samsung issued a recall on the Galaxy Note 7 because of safety concerns. They are stopping all production on the Galaxy 7. Okay? They're stopping all production. They're stopping it. You know what that means?
Halt. Stop. They're not making any more.
That means it could be collectible. You never know.
The assembly line is shut down.
They could be, you know, and you may be right, Alex. They may be as collectible as those valuable tulips.
2.5 million devices they made so far. 2.5 million.
2.5 million devices, phones. which is crazy. So, the company halted sales and recalled 2.5 million devices manufactured, and it then shipped replacement devices that were deemed to be safe by both Samsung and the U.S. Consumer. Product Safety Commission. Unfortunately, it turns out those devices no safer than the first time around. And can you believe that? This is a huge deal.
It has something to do with the battery, right? And it's the same battery the other phones use, yeah. Lithium-ion batteries.
Yeah. So the battery is the problem. So if you purchased a Note 7 even, right? I think they're recalling those as well. If I'm not mistaken, they are. So the bottom line is this. I've never heard of any recall this big on the... I mean, can you imagine not being able to take a phone on a plane? What do? You have to leave it at the checkpoint?
Pretty soon it's not going to matter because nobody's going to have these phones.
Now, you're not supposed to take it into your checked luggage. So if you check your luggage, are they scanning... Not only for a phone, but for a Samsung Galaxy S7? Is there some kind of S7 detector? Anyway, it's... regardless, it is what it is, right? The Note 7, Samsung's best device ever, and arguably the best big phone ever made. And it costs you, let's see... okay, Alex, you're talking about it.
It's a big phone.
It will cost you $849 more, depending on carrier, if you pre-ordered it. But this is before. But the bottom line is they...
You can't get them.
It's crazy. It's just crazy. You want to see another picture? Check this out. Look at that. That's hazardous, is it not? Hello?
Yeah, I'd like to get my screen repaired because the thing caught on fire and turned into a smoldering heap of electronics.
You know, I forgot to check if we can hear the audio on this or not. I probably, maybe. I don't know. But here, this is a story from Florida about this Jeep that, a guy.
No, 10 o'clock, up in flames. Look at this. The St. Pete man says his brand new Samsung Galaxy Note 7 phone started a fire that torched his beloved Jeep. There's been a nationwide recall on those devices after dozens have also caught fire. Josh Cassio is live in St. Pete with more on this exclusive story. Josh, that's scary stuff.
Yeah, Mark, you know, we use our phones every single day. Nobody ever thinks something like this could cause so much damage, but that's what we're seeing. This is a major problem for Samsung. It's a major problem for Samsung Note owners. And there is a recall, but unfortunately for this guy, he didn't know about it, well, until it was too late.
It was very surprising to me how quick the dash caught on fire. Once it got the dash, the airbags went and started exploding. And I had it bored out 6.4 liter. It wasn't a regular vehicle to me. I mean, I'd done a lot of modifications to it and really enjoyed this vehicle.
It's hard for St. Pete's Nathan Dornicker to see his beloved Jeep like this. It's even harder when you consider what sparked it.
That's the last thought in my head, is that a brand new device, something as simple as a phone, is going to burn down my car or my house or hurt a family member.
That new phone, one of these, a Samsung Galaxy Note 7, one of the newest to hit the market.
I converted from Apple phones back when the some of the first Notes were out, and I've had every new Note since then.
It was charging in the SUV when it blew up like a ticking time bomb. He'd only had it 4 days.
I don't think I'm gonna let another Samsung product in my house.
He says he's gotten the runaround from the manufacturer and wasn't aware of the recall. Officially, the company says there have only been a small number of battery cell issues, 35 as of September 1st. Samsung has stopped selling the phone and is offering replacements, saying, quote, the safety and satisfaction of our customers is Samsung's top priority.
Was enjoying it. I didn't have any issues with it up until this point.
He knows he's lucky no one was hurt, including his 8-year-old daughter, who often had the phone in her tiny hands.
Hello?
And insurance will pay for the car, but he'll still likely be out thousands of dollars for the modifications that he did to it. It's also the family vehicle, so that's putting them in a bind as well. Again, all because of a simple phone just like this one. Mark, one more thing I want to point out. Just moments ago, we got an email from a representative from Samsung specifically about this case. They say, quote, we are aware of the incident and are working with Mr. Dorniker to investigate his case and ensure we do everything we can for him. So it sounds like following our story, things are happening. We'll have an update at 11 to see exactly where it goes from here. Back to you.
We are glad they're going to be okay. Could have been much worse. Josh Cascio tonight for us. Josh, thanks very much.
All right. So there you go. Now, since then, that's an old story because you can't get it anymore. Hey, I was just trying this Facebook Live deal, right? Is that right? Is it? Can we put that like Alex? How do I do that? Something like that?
I don't know.
Alex, you should be Snapchatting about this.
Alex, you should be helping me, man.
Yeah.
Alex, you should be helping me.
I don't know what to do.
You're on Snapchat.
Yeah,
you should Snapchat that we're on Kid Friday.
No.
Yeah, Alex. Oh, maybe this. How about this? Hold on.
Stand by, please.
All right.
We're experiencing technical difficulties. Please stand by.
There are no difficulties. Just
just challenges. Except,
except,
challenges.
For, except for your bad jokes. Okay. Hold on. I guess if I could. Hold on. Stand by. Maybe we could use this magnifying glass to boost it up. That's high tech for you right there, huh? That's high tech. Look at this.
We're experiencing technical difficulties. Please stand.
All right, Alex, maybe you can help me out on that one, huh? You think?
I don't know what to do.
You don't know what to do?
Okay.
Lean it up against. We're trying to be live on Facebook right now, folks.
Yeah, I noticed that.
There we go. Look at that.
Yeah, look at that. So, you know, I'm always too late. So-and-so was live on Facebook.
Me too.
So-and-so was live on Facebook. You know, if I was smart, I would put on the Kid Friday page, hey, we're going to be live at da-da-da-da. You can tune in, right? Okay. So, have you ever seen anyone live on Facebook?
At that moment, no. It's always... was live.
Yeah, okay. So.
Or no, actually, well, I've never seen, I get reminders that say so-and-so is live. The funny thing is it's all people I don't really care if they're live or not.
Really?
I mean, not alive, I mean live on video.
You know, that's really interesting because we're friends with some of the same people and I've seen these people's names that have been live and now I know that you don't care about them. Mm-hmm. So, interesting.
What?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Yeah.
Huh?
You know exactly what I'm saying there.
I mean, I don't care
friend.
About them. I'm just, I don't necessarily care that they're shoe shopping and they're live. Facebooking about it. So-and-so is live at DSW Shoe Warehouse.
Is that what they do? I've never seen anyone live on Facebook. Always after the fact. I'm going to tease you with this one,
again,
though.
Not
I'm going to tease you with this one because this is the big kahuna right here. Look at that. Oh, no, that's not the right one. That's the... hold on, check. Here it is right here. Look at that.
Don't do it.
That's
oh
the big
God,
rack. That's
that.
That's the big boy.
Big rack.
That's
oh rotisserie.
Matter of fact, I don't. I mean, that's look at it's
you
just come,
in,
look at
in
look
in
at more and more chicken coming towards you like crazy. Is that nuts?
It's like a 3D effect.
That's just
woo.
Oh man, oh. Less hungry,
more
hungry.
Hungry,
less hungry, more hungry.
Alex,
less,
you getting hungry?
More.
What? Alex, you getting hungry?
Less?
Yeah,
of course he is. And we have 45 minutes to get to Costco before they close, and I'd love to go with you guys if I can because I like that. Alex. Alex likes the way I shop, I think, at Costco. Do you
not? Yeah, it's pretty funny.
It is. Seriously, right? Go ahead. How do I shop at Costco? I'm not a member, okay? So if I ever want to go to Costco, I go with these guys, okay? You know? And so I'm not there much. So go ahead. Share your shopping experience with me at Costco.
He just walks around, and then if he finds something, he's like, oh, I need that. And then you throw it in. I don't know, just like a normal shopper.
Oh, well, that's not such a good story. I did ask Alex last time about dishwashing stuff. We looked at what it said. You know, it fights stains and cleans. I said, I think I need that one because the other one didn't say that or something like that. So
sometimes I think you go in there and you don't necessarily you buy things you don't necessarily want or need at that moment, but
okay.
You see it and you got to get
okay. So you're not okay. There are these guys, and I'm telling you, and I kid you not, you just reminded me of this, okay? There's these guys that go around to different supermarkets, including Costco, and they rate rotisserie chickens.
What?
Okay, and that's what I watch. That's one of the things I watch while I was eating my rotisserie chicken.
I should have come up with this idea.
And they're in L.A., and they went to, like, Ralph's, and they went to... here, if I go, just type in best rotisserie chicken.
There it is.
And there's these guys that it's great.
Which grocery store has the best rotisserie chicken?
These guys are awesome. You won't be able to hear the audio, unfortunately, but I'm going to show you that you can. There's so much to learn.
See, once again, YouTube.
These guys are great. Now, this is from 2015, okay? And I'm going to throw it on right now. Oh, I did throw it on there, didn't I? What is this? Some kind of commercial.
This is scary. Get that out.
30-second commercial because it's so popular. Yeah, these guys are awesome.
Chicken Watch 2015.
Yeah, they're looking for the best rotisserie chicken, all right? And they're cruising along. They have their criteria, all right? And I will say that as they get down to, like, the fifth and sixth store, they have a little chicken fatigue.
That's going to happen.
You know, they've eaten a little too much rotisserie chicken. And then there's a guy in the back who reads out chicken facts while they're driving along to the next location. Hmm. This is very, very well done. Maybe we'll throw a link on that on the Kid Friday page. But they just showed they say you know how old this looking at the time the chicken was made, the whole thing.
It's a lot to consider.
Chicken Watch, there it is. Chicken Watch 2K15. You got to watch that. That's what I do. You know, depending on what I eat
and what you need to do.
It was awesome watching this while eating a rotisserie chicken. It's fantastic. What?
If you need to know how to get a good, great rotisserie chicken, find out the best one, where do you go? You go to YouTube. You want to find out how to solve the Rubik's Cube? Go to YouTube.
They do the flick test, and because they want to see if you take the chicken bone and you flick it, if the chicken just flies off, that's a good thing. Some of it, they just pull it up, and just the bone.
Very tender.
Nothing to flick. That's pretty amazing.
I'm impressed because so far there's no chicken grease on any of their shirts.
See, but you thought I was kidding about, you know, watching what you eat.
Literally, you can watch what you eat.
So
actually watch what you eat.
So the thing is that only eat good stuff because some of the stuff that I've eaten and then I've watched how it's made, I have not eaten again. Chicken Watch 2K15.
And now it's time for Chicken Watch 2K16.
I'm telling you. And then, matter of fact, they go to Costco. They don't have a membership. So they talk to this lady, and she goes in and gets them a chicken. She comes out, she helps them review.
That'd make a good movie, wouldn't it? In a world where two men are looking for the best rotisserie chicken.
A lot of chicken. It's a lot of chicken flying all over the place. You know? A lot of chicken. You know, after all of this, I'm thinking that you might not get your chicken in time. Is it a good Costco chicken? I believe it was 50 cents less than
really
anyone
good,
else.
And it is a dollar, $2 less than anyone else, yes.
It is. Because I'm a big fan.
But it is really good.
I'm a big fan of the rotisserie chicken.
We like going to Costco with you. It's a win-win for all.
Do you? All right, we better end the show then. So we talked about the fire on the Jeep. Okay, so on YouTube, speaking of YouTube, okay, I can't, okay. So growing up, my father, he taught me a lot of things, but nothing about how to fix things, how to do anything. He blew up the electricity in our house. He had me accidentally, I cut through a gas line. We had the fire department out, I remember, as a kid. He blew out the circuits. I can't pound a nail straight. Okay,
can't draw a straight line with a ruler.
I don't know. And you should do Alex. You should do a video on growing tulips. Actually,
no,
because I think people would really be interested in that.
No.
So the check engine light comes on. Not the check engine light. The yellow, the orange one. Service engine soon. I'm like, oh, what is this? So I go over to the auto parts, Advanced, I think. AutoZone. And they plug in the thing for free.
The diagnostic. Tell what the light is all about.
Yeah, diagnostic. And it spits out a bunch of codes. Bottom line is, oh, yeah, you need a new ignition coil. I'm like, man, No. The person there is like, no, it's not that hard. Here's what you do. Anyway, I went on YouTube, and I checked out, check this out.
I'm going to show you how to change your spark plugs and change your ignition coil as well.
All right, the music was way too loud for me because it's hard to hear. But the bottom line is this, is that you take off two little screws, you take off that plastic cover, your ignition coils are right there. You just pop it up. You pull the deal out. You put the new ignition coil in. Boom, boom,
however,
boom,
we should have
done.
A disclaimer considering our audience. Kids, do not try this at home without your parents or your parents' permission.
Absolutely. That's
do
correct.
Not,
do That's
not
correct.
Start taking apart the car based on things that you saw on YouTube without your parents' permission.
But listen to this. When I hear the word ignition coil, I have no idea what I'm talking about. Or they're talking about. What's an ignition coil? And then I discover that an ignition coil is so easy to change, it is like adding oil to your car. Or growing
so did you do
tulips.
It?
Yeah, I did it. I actually went on eBay and bought an ignition coil for about... So the store wanted $51 for one ignition coil for my car. And by the way, the video is for the same engine that I have. So it's exactly. And I bought it for $13.95, free shipping. You can still drive it. Wow. It just drove a little rough. And I changed the ignition coil.
A couple years ago.
I'm going to show you how to change your spark plugs and change your ignition coil as well.
That music got me so excited, I just couldn't wait. Sorry, what?
I was going to say a couple years ago, because I've always been pretty good at taking things apart. Mm-hmm. It's putting them all back together and fixing something can be tough.
Sure.
So I learned how to do my...
That could be like a song. Everything falls apart.
Everything falls apart.
And then you got to put it back together.
Exactly.
That'd be interesting.
But I learned how to... I changed an alternator in my car, thanks to YouTube. I did brakes on my car, thanks to YouTube. I learned what was wrong. Have not fixed it yet, but learned what is wrong with my dishwasher in my house that doesn't work anymore, thanks to Where Else YouTube. And all these people, like that guy there, he has his own channel. They're basically a car repair channel. It's professional people. There's a home improvement guy who does, how to fix your appliances and
stuff. These guys at the dealerships aren't liking this conversation right now.
No.
All right? The service department is not... They want to always make it sound like it's a huge mystery. Oh, yeah, you need a new ignition coil. Boy, that's, how much labor is that? You know what? It's 5 minutes labor.
You're going to need a left-handed...
It's 5 minutes. It's 5 minutes labor. I kid you not, it's 5 minutes.
Yeah, we're going to have to...
That's about an hour and a half labor, and then, we'll have to probably reseat this, and then, and then, oh,
we're going to have to...
Let's not forget about shop supplies.
And shop supplies. What are shop supplies? Well, we needed a left-handed smoke shifter and a Finnegan's wrench. What are you talking about? It's under shop supplies.
You need a special tool that that you can't buy. You ever hear that?
Yep.
You need a special tool. Yeah. You need a special tool.
Just you wait, Alex. You're a year away from your
learner's
permit and driving, huh?
You know what? Just wait, Alex, because I'm telling you, that I can't believe that I changed my ignition coil and I didn't even know what an ignition coil is. Do you know what it is?
No. Could you explain it?
No. Why don't you just go to YouTube and find out for yourself?
Just like you do with your magic tricks and Rubik's Cube and Snapchat.
Show some magic. Can you show,
I don't do that.
Hey,
I can't.
Can you show us some magic? I think I have a deck of cards here.
I can't remember any tricks.
Some magic?
All right, what we'll do is we'll go on YouTube, we'll relearn the tricks, and then for the next episode, you'll do a couple tricks. How's that, Alex?
Maybe.
All right, I'll tell you what we're going to do.
Like the one where I have to pick a card and I was wrong. I remember you guessed it every single time.
It's not technology.
You learned it on YouTube, so that's technology.
Hey, by the way, if you do own a Samsung phone, you can go in and you can you have to bring your phone back, and they give you credit towards another phone. You pick out some kind of phone you want. So you have to bring your phone back.
I bet there's a YouTube video on how to make sure your Samsung Galaxy S7 Note does not catch on fire. It's a very short video. All it is don't get one.
You know, so it just so happens that I have a bunch of kind of retro stuff laying around here. We had showed them on a previous show a long time ago, but let me see if I can go to camera. The desk cam. Look at that. Huh? What do you think of the desk cam, guys? What do you think of that? Look at this.
There's what in the world is that?
That's a Nokia flip phone. Look at that. That is a flip phone. Is that, you know, flip phones I think are going to come back.
That's back when it was
because
really trendy to have the smallest phone possible.
I think, really?
Yeah, remember those little Motorola ones, the little antenna? They're about the size of a chiclet.
I'd rather carry this in my pocket than some giant S mongoloid. Look at that. Just opens up. All right. What do you think of that? You like that one?
Frankly, I think you look pretty foolish if you have an iPad-sized tablet up to your ear and you're talking to it.
Now, how about this one? This was a free one from AT&T back in the day. All right? The Pantech. You like that?
I love it. I wish I had all the BlackBerries that I...
Look at that. Huh?
Went through. QWERTY.
QWERTY keyboard. QWERTY keyboard. Look at that. You can... Look at that.
I wanted one of those with a mysterious hidden keyboard.
You know, every
one time
I misspell stuff so bad, I'm pushing.
Well, BlackBerry's had or have the QWERTY keyboard, and I'm telling you, I was so good with that keyboard, I could have typed a book with my BlackBerry keyboard. Now it's swiping, and you know, which I kind of like. I didn't think I'd ever get used to that. But
we spoke about this. This is the original iPhone. This is the iPhone 1, I guess you'd call it, but they just called it the iPhone, and it is. There you go, right there. Can you see that?
Alex, you just got an iPhone, right?
Yes.
But it's an older generation, right?
It's a 5S.
It's a 5S.
But it still works great?
Yep.
You dig it?
What?
You dig it? 5S is great.
Yeah.
5S is a great phone.
Do you like it better than your LG?
It's the original.
Way better.
Do you go to the App Store and get apps?
Yep.
Hey, you just took that off the desk cam while we had Alex. See, now we have nothing on the desk.
There you go.
All right, now you can. I'm just kidding. Now you can take it away. Check this out, the very first cassette Walkman. This is the original Sony Walkman. I found out they're going for like $250 on eBay or something like that.
Wow. Do you remember the Sony Discman?
Sure, I remember the Discman.
With bass boost?
Do you remember the mini disc? I have several of them discovered.
Mini disc, oh my gosh, I remember that.
Let's see now what else. Oh, check this out. I think these are getting, here's another phone. But this is the rotary style iPods. This is a 60 gig iPod. I'm gonna pull it out of this with the click wheel that goes around.
I still have in my gym bag right now. I used it today at the gym. An actual Rio MP3 player, and it works great.
Look at that! Look at that! That's some shiny chrome.
The size of an iPod Nano. Remember those?
The little one.
Yeah. But
yeah.
It's got a little screen and everything. I love that thing.
There's the original. No, it's not the original. The original iPod was thinner.
But it still looks.
This is thicker because it's a 60 gig.
It still looks. It doesn't
it's
look,
in great shape.
It doesn't look old.
No, it it's, doesn't. And
know,
the and
design's timeless on those.
It is. And you can, you know what? If you've never used one of these, then you've never used
one of these. So we know the iPhone replace those, but Alex, you had an iPod Touch for a while, but that wasn't a phone.
I have an iPhone here.
But what was the iPod Touch?
Oh no, here's an iPod. Here's an iPod right here. Here's an iPod Touch.
All right, so the iPod Touch kind of replaced the regular iPod.
You want an iPod Touch,
right, Alex? You had one.
Yeah, I did.
Here's one right here. This is an 8 gig iPod Touch.
I had a newer one than that.
But so it was basically a phone without the phone function, right?
Yep.
Was that what a touch was? But now you can't get an iPod Touch anymore, right?
Well, if you did, you just
get a phone.
You could just get Google Voice, and as long as you're connected to Wi-Fi, you could call anyone you want.
Over iPod things. With an iPod Touch.
Yeah. 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 This is a thinner one.
I just thought the iPod Touch was. I mean, it was. Why don't you just get a phone then?
I'm just
looking around.
That's true.
I'm looking around to see what else I can find. I found a wrench. How about a wrench?
There's a remote control over there. Look at that.
This is a wrench, and I have no idea how to use it.
For the next Kid Friday, kids.
If I go on YouTube, I'm sure I could find out.
For the next Kid Friday, one of us are going to bring in a rotary phone.
Oh,
remember rotary phones?
Sweet.
I love rotary phones.
I had a rotary phone. Gave it to someone in the office. They brought it to their cabin, and I had it converted to take a regular.
Well, I loved rotary.
Oh, there we are.
All right. Okay. Hello.
You liked what?
I loved the rotary phone as a kid because if you dialed something that had like ones or twos and threes, it was a really fast dial and you felt really important and powerful. Just and then you would slow up if it was a 7, 8, or 9. You have to put the dial all the way around. You know.
What'd you say?
Yeah.
What does that mean? All right. Well, nothing personal. We'd love to tell you more about kids and technology and apps. There's some great new apps out. Oh man, there are some great new apps. And by the way, we did speak about this video. Is there a phone? Is one of those my phone?
Your phone is doing Facebook Live at the moment.
Oh yeah,
Alex, did you get any new apps recently with your iPhone?
Autoblog
nope.
VR.
Oh, that's great.
Autoblog VR. It's a free app. You get it. You can choose the car you want, and it's got a 300. The big thing now are 360 degree cameras, and so you can get a 360 degree camera. And it's like you're driving in the car. You turn like this, and you're looking out the left side of the car.
Is it a game?
It's just cool. Just get it. It's free. Autoblog VR.
Alex, you haven't got a single new app.
Nope. Not
Alex,
recently.
Why don't you get it? Because
are you still using Snapchat and Instagram?
Can you get it really quick? So we can see it?
My phone's over there.
Over there?
Yeah, it's back there.
You lazy kids.
How many Instagram followers do you have now?
I don't know.
Over 400?
No.
300?
Yeah.
There's another rotisserie chicken, by the way.
Again with a rotisserie chicken.
All right. Is there anything else you want to talk about? Because I had a bunch of stuff that I wanted to talk about.
Well, let's go for it.
But, one thing, you know, since we are talking about phones and everything, Verizon has a new data plan. And it's called Pop Data, 30 and 60 minute all you can stream 4G LTE sessions at $2 or $3, because we're just trying out you can't see it, but we're trying out this Facebook Live thing. Okay, I've never tried it and I've never seen anyone on it before except someone was on it, right?
Right.
So now Verizon has so if you want to stream. And 4G, we'll let you do it, for 30 minutes for $2, 60 minutes for $3.
So, kids, ask your parents for more streaming sessions.
Or you can get an all-you-can-stream thing.
It's funny because I got a notification from my provider, T-Mobile, today, like I always do, the middle of every month, that I've used up all, I think I have 1 gig of high-speed data, then it goes to slow. So it gives me a warning. You've used 800 megabytes of your 1 gig high-speed data plan. A little warning. I never make it past the middle of the month before it goes to slow.
You should get more data.
When you go slow, it's...
But I'm on Wi-Fi all the time. You would think I'm not using it, but you check Facebook a few times, or you upload a photo or two, and you can go through it pretty quick.
Yeah, they call it throttling. And when they throttle you, they slow you down. It's interesting that... not only on phones now, but I got an email from Xfinity. Did you get one?
Mm-mm.
Saying that we are going to start to charge. They're going to have data caps. Okay? based on usage. So it says, according to our records, we're going to be coming out with this thing, and according to our records, this is how much usage you have had over the past few months, and we determined that you probably will not need to upgrade to a bigger plan. Of course, they're just teasing you. Because right. They're just telling you that they're going to start charging for extra. You can get an extra 5 gig for X amount of money, an extra whatever. So, and I knew this was coming because I watch all of my television online. You know, I use an online service. And so I'm constantly using Wi-Fi at the house. And, eventually you're going to hit some data caps.
No doubt.
So if you have Xfinity for your Wi-Fi, you might want to, if you haven't seen the email, if your parents haven't gotten an email yet or whatever, they may be coming to you saying, listen, you gotta stop with especially peer-to-peer games really eat up a lot of data.
Alex,
you know, like a PSP, you know, or whatever, they eat up tons of data. You know, yes, streaming movies and everything,
that reminds me.
But peer-to-peer stuff, huge.
Alex,
sorry.
That's what you do. What game have you been playing on your phone with a friend of yours?
What
game have you been playing on your phone with a friend of yours?
Galaga?
Nothing.
No, pool. You've been playing pool.
That's texting.
That's a game. But it's peer to peer. I've seen it. It looks like a little pool table, right?
It's texting though.
But
so
it's a pool table.
It's not an app.
Is it a game?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Well, that's what I'm talking about. Peer to peer. That's what Dave's talking about.
Yeah. So, you're already warning him. It sounds like you're already scolding him.
Sorry.
To not play pool with his.
No, but
the kid
it's a perfect example of what you're just talking about, right? I mean, you know, it's using data to keep track of, you know, what two people are doing, playing a game live, right? But didn't I ask you? I remember the other day you took a shot in the pool game, and I said, "Oh, you're playing your friend right now," and you said, "No," right? So they get an alert. What's that game called?
Pool.
Got it. Thanks. It's got to have a name like Pool Challenge, Pool Frenzy, Billiards Deluxe.
Minnesota Fats.
Pool.
Great. Thanks.
Is the name.
It's called Pool.
Yeah.
Give Tulip Boy a break. It's called Pool.
All right. You win.
But these data caps are coming, and so be forewarned that if your parents come to you and say, hey, how come our bill went from, you know, $80 to $200? And $80. Oh, I've been I played until 2 a.m. with my friend Farm Frenzy, whatever. What's it called? Frenzy with Farmville?
Nobody still plays that, do they?
No, Farm something Farm. Farm
Farmer Fred Frenzy?
Farm
Alex, help us out. What's
I don't
the name
know. Come on. Farm.
I have no idea.
Farm, you're a real hip kid.
The big
with technology.
One. Farm.
Farmville.
Is that what it is?
It's the one on Facebook.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe that's what it is.
All right. Hey.
Yeah.
I just thought of something. There's a new scam going on we should tell people about.
Really?
Yeah.
What's up?
So this happened twice this week, and I know a couple of people this happened to. My phone rings. I look down at it, and the incoming call.
And the incoming call says.
The number is my number.
Really? So it's your number?
I'm not kidding you.
We've had this chicken up the whole time.
Oh, again with the chicken.
I think we had the chicken up the whole time.
All right. So there's this phone scam going on.
Sorry.
Seriously. So twice this week, within a couple of days, and I was just talking to somebody, a couple of friends about it, and this happened to them too. My phone rings. You look down, you see who's calling, see what number it is, and it was my phone number the incoming number.
You're calling yourself.
So that's what it looked like, exactly. I answer it. This is weird. Hello. And there's a lot of noise in the background, and then the person talking sounds like English is definitely a second language for them, and they start telling me that there's something wrong with my computer, and they know how to fix it.
So now you want to have a ban on Muslims. Is that what you're trying to say?
I didn't say that at all. How do I know what the religion is? But the truth I'm just saying it sounded like they were far away in a call center, and that English was not their native tongue. I'm sure the kids' parents.
So you want to ban anyone into this country that doesn't speak that speaks with a native tongue? Is that what you're saying?
I never said that. I never said that. Honest.
You implied it.
But no. But what I am implying is that there's a phone scam out there, and I'm not kidding. There's a couple of people that the same thing happened to, and one friend of mine, she kept talking to them about it, and they kept saying, give us your email address. She said, nope, thank you, and they hung up.
Give us your email address.
So here's a crazy thing that these things I get these calls from numbers
they'll be able to reset your password with your phone number and email address.
But that's crazy. I mean, that could be really dangerous. They get
and then they'll be playing pool using all your data.
You like to think there's nobody not smart enough to fall for that scam, right? But clearly people still do things like that. People still fall for this stuff because they keep coming up with these scams, these phone calls. Here's another example. Do you get this one,
Dave? But wait, there's more.
Do you ever get this one? Phone rings and you answer the phone. You don't recognize the number. I mean, I get bored sometimes and I'm lonely, so I'll answer the phone no matter who calls. So
I thought you had a girlfriend.
I do, but I don't see.
Well, you know what? You didn't imply it that way. I think that's pretty rude.
I'm sorry.
I think you're not being sensitive to people who have English as a second language.
Oh, again with this.
I think you're being very insensitive. It's very improper. All right, go ahead.
So I answer the phone even though I don't recognize the number, and there's a long pause. There's like 10, I don't say, sometimes I don't even say hello because if I don't know the number, I want them to say something first. And there's a bit of a pause for like 5 or 6 seconds. And all of a sudden, it's an automated voice. Hello. Don't worry. There is not an emergency with your credit card. And it's some scam. And I don't even listen to the whole thing.
Press 1 to talk to our.
Do you get that one?
No, but you know what?
Hello. This is an important message about your credit card.
I get multiple emails every day. And it says with stuff like attached is. The itinerary that we spoke about.
Right.
And it's a zip file.
Yep.
And you do not want to open those zip files, okay? Or attached are the notes that we spoke about yesterday.
So what's the bottom line here? Never open any attachments from an email source that you don't know who they are.
You looking for some attachments back there, Alex?
Are you okay?
Tulips?
Yeah, I'm fine.
All right.
You okay there, buddy?
What's wrong? So, but
this stuff still goes on all the time, and it's like playing whack-a-mole. It's just as soon as you shut down. There was one a couple months ago, and I actually looked it up online. There was a number I saw the area code came from New York, and it was an automated phone call saying, you owe the IRS money, and you must call this number right away to fix this problem.
Oh, yeah, big scam. The IRS will never
you. Yeah, but again, this happens enough where people fall for it, where they keep doing it.
You probably fell for it because you probably owe the IRS a lot of money.
I sent them $1.39.
Oh, just a guess.
And a coupon for a rotisserie chicken.
You know, the rotisserie chicken, I'm looking for a good picture of...
So plump and
for juicy. For the rotisserie chicken, and we'll take a look
no
at
it. No more rotisserie chicken,
We'll take a look at this one.
Stop teasing me. At least throw some side dishes up there.
Yeah, so. Look at that.
Little mashed potatoes.
Oh, wrong. Oh, hold on. I'm on the wrong one there.
Tater tots.
There we go.
Some tots.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Look at that bird.
The bird is... Oy. Yo, you're not going to get... We're not going to make it.
That's all right. We'll go to Cub.
I'm sorry.
We'll go to the grocery store.
I'm sorry. We're not going to make it. I wanted to get
Alex,
some of
do you
that.
Have homework tonight?
I wanted to get some.
I don't
are you
know.
Sure they're not open till 7?
I checked. It's Sunday. I did. Honestly, I checked. And Alex has homework tonight, we think. Hey, we had parent-teacher conference. This guy right here in the middle here, straight A's.
You know what? I had parent-teacher conferences for my daughter Zoe, straight A's.
Pretty proud.
Let's go.
Pretty proud.
Game on. Let's
give a round of applause.
How old are you, Alex?
14.
Uh-huh. Interesting. Are you sure?
Yep.
A in human geography, which is a new course, apparently.
Yeah.
And A something in English, but you owe a couple assignments, she said.
I asked...
And A in Spanish. What instrument do you play in orchestra?
Oh, viola.
You had your first concert, what was it, last week? Sounded amazing.
Hold on. You're taking Spanish?
Yep.
Yeah.
Are you taking Spanish as a second language?
Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
Huh? Are you?
Technically, he is.
Interesting. Don't call me.
My feelings are hurt. Alex, don't do any phone scams. Got it? Or else you're grounded.
You know that? Hola. So that's why your dad said hola.
Hey, you remember we were talking about rotary phones before a few minutes ago?
See how you like changing the subject?
This ever happened to you?
See, when you know what? You remind me of someone. You're trying to see.
I just thought of a really good story. So when I was a kid, we had the rotary phone, and then they brought out touch tone phones with the, you press all the individual buttons. So about a month after having it, my grandmother says, who has been messing around with the phone? Right?
Mm-hmm.
No idea what she's talking about. Who called Costa Rica and South America? What happened was, I was so excited as a kid to get this new phone, I would pick up the receiver. There we go. Throw those pictures up there. There's a rotisserie phone. Rotisserie phone. Oh, my goodness. I got rotisserie chicken on the brain, folks. That's a rotary dial phone you're going to see come up here.
You think so?
That's a hopefully soon.
What do you mean hopefully soon? How about now?
Bam. Look at that.
That's a rotary phone.
That's a rotary phone. You'd stick your finger in those little circles, turn it clockwise.
Does that fit in your pocket?
See, that's what I'm talking about. Look at that. One, two, and three with that little chrome thing. You could dial it so fast. But what I did was, when we got the Touchtone phone, I started banging away on it with my index finger, pressing all these numbers at once to see what happened. Mm-hmm. And apparently I called South America and it cost $23. And my grandmother was very unhappy. I may have gotten grounded. I may have got hit with the receiver of the phone. I'm not exactly sure.
So now that explains it all. I think it's all coming true. Here's a Touchtone phone.
Here's a crazy thing. Our first Touchtone phone. Guess what color it was?
Red.
Was it?
I didn't even tell you that, and you pulled that up automatically.
You know what? It's just amazing like that.
And I used to take it apart. That plastic piece around the numbers there, I used to take it apart. Look at that.
Oh.
Alex, go to YouTube and find the magic trick to put a phone up on.
Show us a magic trick. Can you just? We're gonna wrap things up, but can you show us a magic trick?
I don't know any magic tricks
anymore. Come on. Your dad was like totally just.
That was like 3 years ago. I don't know any.
Do you know any non-English magic tricks?
No.
Huh?
But my dad wouldn't like that.
I know some magic tricks. Look at that. I pulled that piece of candy out of your ear.
Okay. If I had a deck of cards.
Kids, do you have that obnoxious crazy uncle that always pulls a quarter out from behind his ear?
Or your ear? Oh, I thought I had a deck of cards around here somewhere.
Actually, it's been a few years. I don't think Alex is kidding when he says he doesn't remember the card trick. It's been several years.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
We won't put you on the spot, but next time.
Then why were you bragging about his non-English Spanish?
What?
I think we made our
point. Can I change the subject pretty quickly now?
All right. Now, we're going to wrap things up here on Kid Friday. We can't thank you enough for joining us. If you have a Samsung S7, you got to take it back. You can't bring it on an airplane. It's a hazard. It's dangerous. And you probably don't have one, but your mom and dad might. And you got to take it back. Have to. It's a mandatory recall. All right? The Department of Transportation and the whole thing. You got to bring it back. Can't get the Samsung Galaxy tablet either. All right? Discontinued. Boom. Bye. Samsung is coming out with a Chromebook Pro that actually has some really good specs, but I don't know much about the battery.
Yeah, so hopefully it won't turn into a smoldering heap of electronics.
Didn't want to talk too much about that. But this is a 2016 Kid Friday production. All rights reserved. Don't mess with us, or we're going to send Alex to your house and plant some tulips where the sun don't shine. All right. Any final words, guys?
Final words, Alex?
None.
None?
I don't have any.
None. Nope. Is that what it's just called? None? Like pool? Pool? Yeah. Is the game pool. Just called pool?
Yeah.
All you can say is none?
Yep.
And what about your dad? Go ahead and tell us a joke that we won't understand.
No jokes. I was gonna say though, kids, ask your parents to show you to see. Ask them if they still have a rotisserie dial phone in their basement. I mean, a rotary dial phone. I gotta get something to eat. That rotisserie chicken. But ask them if they've got a grandma and grandpa have an old rotary phone somewhere. Go to Goodwill. You might be able to find one and play around with that for a little bit because it's a lot of fun.
Our cousins have one.
Is it fun?
They do.
Is it fun for people that speak all languages?
Most likely, yes. I believe it is because dialing a phone is universal.
You know, it's interesting. So you get a call, and it's got your own phone number. You call it. So when you answer, you say hello, and then you go, hello, how are you? And then you start talking to yourself. Yeah, fine. What's going on? Oh, not much. It was pretty good. Nice day out. I don't understand.
Kind of, sort of. But one time I picked up the phone, and the guy said, do you have Prince Albert in a can? All right.
Well, we can't thank you enough. Now, let me go to the desk cam for a second because I needed some new guitar strings, and I thought this was kind of cool. You know, well, maybe you've seen this before, Steve. I don't know. I'm just going to throw this little thing right. See if I can. Here, I'll hold it up. You can. You know, I use a guitar pick, and you can design your own guitar pick.
Oh, yeah. Those are really cool.
And I was thinking, wow, wouldn't it be cool if we got some Kid Friday guitar picks?
Absolutely.
Or something like that?
Or weaponofselfdistraction.com guitar picks?
That's
or maybe
right.
That won't fit on.
That's right. Why don't you go ahead and, as we say on this kid's show, pimp your podcast. Go ahead. Tell us about how we can listen to your podcast. How do we find it?
Just go to weaponofselfdistraction.com.
That's too long.
Well, we'll work.
I don't even know how to. But you know what?
Selfdistraction.com.
Google. We'll correct
Type
it.
That in there. It'll pop up.
Okay.
I get pretty high on the search results, and we'll have a pod. We got a podcast there coming. We've got one. We're gonna have cool guests. Lots of fun talking about things that distract you.
What can you? Could you give us a real quick little glimpse of what currently distracts you besides me giving you a hard time about?
And besides rotisserie chicken?
And rotisserie chicken. And phones and rotary phones. No, but like what's distracting you? Forget anything I said at the moment,
podcast. There's about 7 or 8 podcasts that are must listen to every single week.
Joe Rogan,
love Joe Rogan, the really? Sklar brothers, the smartest man in the room, a guy by the name of Greg Proops. There's lots of kids podcasts, obviously, like this one. Alex, what else is distracting us?
You know, Story Cub, you can see get it on a podcast, by the way.
There you go. We're looking forward to the new Jack Reacher movie. That's a distraction. We saw The Accountant the other night. That was a good distraction.
Books are pretty distracting
and,
for me.
And books are. What are you reading right now, Alex?
Of Mice and Men.
And weren't you... So the classic book from the 1950s.
Get up there.
Of Mice and Men. You just started an English class?
Yes.
And weren't you reading Percy Jackson, Lightning Thief?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you done with that?
No.
Are you going to finish it?
No.
What?
I've read it 3 times.
That's true, you have. How many times have you read the Harry Potter books?
Twice.
How many times have you read, what is it, Detergent? Divergent.
Once.
Insurgent.
Once.
Once. And then what was the other one? The Hunger Games. You read all of those, right?
Yeah.
That's right. How many Hunger Games books were there?
3.
3. Kid's a good reader.
I'm glad you're not my dad. Boy, you're just drilling me with questions.
Yeah.
What's the name of the game called? What's the name of the book?
I don't think I was that harsh, was I?
How long did it take you to run the mile, Alex? When was the last time you changed your shoes? When was the, just no? You got to answer quick, like your dad. You answer your dad quick. But
fire away.
How old are you?
14.
What month were you born?
February.
Why are you so tulipy?
What? I'm not.
Why do you like tulips?
I don't.
Then why are we talking about?
Are you anti-flower?
Because you brought them up.
Are you anti-flower, Alex?
No.
Are you anti-tulip?
No.
Why? Why? I can't come up.
Why what?
I can't think that fast. Let's see. What do you like better, blondes or brunettes?
I don't care.
What's your favorite food?
Pizza,
but not rotisserie chicken.
You can't go.
Hey, wait a minute. Your
favorite TV show?
How I Met Your Mother.
Favorite book?
Hunger Games.
Favorite single word?
Stop it.
That's two words.
Sorry. No.
I don't know. I don't have a favorite word.
Can't thank you enough for joining us. And we'll see you on the next Kid Friday. Woo. Tell your friends. By the way, thanks for making Kid Friday the number one technology podcast in the world. Viewed in 214 countries. Can you count to 214? Quick.
Now?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. We'll see you on the next show.
Hit it.
Oh!
Let's get this party started.
All right!
Yeah.